أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Dear respected audience, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Today I thank Almighty Allah for giving me this opportunity to present to you the scientific pursuits of research in an industry setting from the perspective of being an Ahmadi Muslim woman. Briefly, I will share with you how it is to launch a successful research career in an industry being an Ahmadi Muslim woman. The points I will discuss today are, how will you select a scientific career being an Ahmadi Muslim woman? What are the things that you will compare and what are your options in this field? Basically, academia versus the industry research. And how do you make that right choice? Then how will you plan a successful career in the field of interest? In my case, it is autoimmunity and inflammation research, the field that I was interested in. And how is the scientific research in an industry setting so rewarding and interesting? Basically, the key evidence or the guidance for doing pursuing industry research or scientific research comes from the guidance of the Holy Quran to all believers, where Allah says, أَفَلَا يَنْزُرُونَ إِلَى الْإِبَلِ كَيْفَ خُلِقَتْ وَإِلَى السَّمَاءِ كَيْفَ رُفِعَتْ وَإِلَى الْجِبَالِ كَيْفَ نُصِبَتْ وَإِلَى الْأَرْضِ كَيْفَ سُطِحَتْ. Do they then not look at the camels as to how they are created, and at the heaven as how it is raised high, and at the mountains how they are fixed, and at the earth how it is spread? Chapter 88, verse 18-21. Again, Allah says in the Holy Quran, Verily, in the creation of the heavens and the earth, and in the alternation of the night and of the day, there are indeed signs for men of understanding. Surah Al Imran, verse 191. The Holy Quran clearly motivates both men and women to observe, think, and explore with curiosity the laws of nature. The guidance of pursuing a career in science or acquiring knowledge of science comes from the guidance of our beloved master, Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who has enjoined all believers that it is the duty of every Muslim man and every Muslim woman to acquire knowledge. He further enjoined, seek knowledge even if you have to travel to China. China was considered a far-off land, and traveling to China was a hard undertaking. Here it is more referenced to the scientific pursuits of knowledge or pursuit of knowledge in general, and if you have to travel to far-off places such as China. A deep motivation for me for science and the inspiration actually was created at a very early part of my life by my father, late Dr. Hafiz Saleh Muhammad Aladdin, may Allah bless him in heaven, who himself was an eminent scientist in the field of astronomy. Being a Hafiz al-Quran, he was always reflecting on the verses of the Holy Quran and how they correlate with the scientific literature. His highlighting research was providing scientific evidence regarding the occurrence of lunar and solar eclipses with regard to the advent of the promised Messiah, alayhi salatu wasalam. Now coming back to the address of focusing a scientific career and considering what is the role of an Ahmadi Muslim woman. We have to consider this because it's a major point for us. And a scientist career does not preclude an Ahmadi Muslim woman from her responsibilities and obligations that Islam has placed on her in creating a better and a pious society. And all of us are very well aware that these responsibilities are with regard to the family life, to the spouse, as well as being a mother and in raising righteous children. another important aspect or the Islamic teaching for a Ahmadi Muslim woman in pursuing any career in general is the observance of the parda or hijab. Now looking at the Islamic role of an Ahmadi Muslim woman and then looking at the scientific pursuits, it seems quite challenging because both are full-time jobs that an Ahmadi Muslim woman has to perform. And there is a deep consideration. We have to think about two options, academia versus industry. The two points that actually made me decide for an industry career while comparing academia and industry were regarding grant writing in an academia setting. And the grant writing involves that you need to get your own fund for pursuing the scientific research of your interest. While an industry, you don't have this tension of grant writing. Basically, the funding for research is provided by the larger organization. So then you have one less thing to do, but you're still pursuing your science. Then the second major thing about academia is that if you want to flourish and be a productive scientist, you should secure a tenure track position. If you don't have a tenure track position, you may not be able to survive. While in an industry career, the first challenge is initial, and it is finding the right position, the right match, the right research that you want to do in a company, and considering whether a large pharma versus a small biotech. Once you make that decision, you are all set, and you can, with prayers, go forward in your career. Another major appealing point to me was that the industry research is translational. Basically, you are actually delivering a product that is touching the patient's life in the form of a drug or medicine for a life-threatening disease. Then you have to address what is your research interest and what interest you want to pursue further. For me, it was an interest in immunology, and I was interested in doing research in autoimmunity. Autoimmunity, what is autoimmunity actually? It is when your own immune system does not recognize its own cells and tissues and has and attacks them, resulting in tissue damage, resulting in the autoimmune response. And there are a variety of autoimmune diseases prevalent among the patients. The chief among them are the rheumatoid arthritis and lupus, typically referred to as SLE. Both of them have high unmet needs, and there is always a need for new therapies to be available to these patients. This slide actually shows that what we do every day in the industry in making a drug discovery. The process is actually a very long process before the drug or the medicine comes into the market. It takes about 10 to 12 years, and it is a stage gate system. Every stage is defined by a criteria, and transition from one stage to another involves sharp timelines. The early part involves a lot of biology. Now, having come to these points of focus with regard to an industry career, you can well visualize here how a discovery research in industry could be interesting and exciting. The primary point is that it offers a large amount of creativity. Every day is a new day in terms of creativity, challenge, and cutting-edge science, and it gives you an opportunity to work on a variety of novel drug targets that come up new into the field. Recently, we are working on metabolic pathways targets, which tie up with the immune activation pathways. So you can see they are also expressed in a variety of cells other than just being expressed in the immune cells. It helps you to excel in knowledge, and the way it does it, because you will expand your area of research, you will go into other autoimmune diseases. And finally, the fulfillment or the benefit goes to the patients, where you come up with some remedy that will help in reducing their symptoms or causing remission. The Holy Quran has guided us to do service to the humanity. Allah says, "You are the best people created for the good of mankind," chapter 3, verse 111. This slide just shows the cutting edge science that we can do in industry, because the industry gives you all the resources and modern technology. There are no financial constraints, and you can come up with brilliant ideas. Here we have done a humanized mouse. So these mice do not have their own immune system, but their speciality is that they can take up the human cells. So when you put the human cells in them, they they get engrafted in these mice, and you can follow them in the blood by engraftment, and you can look into the different functions of novel targets that would be involved in causing autoimmunity in a human scenario. Basically, I want to wrap up my presentation with giving you a few summary points on how to launch a successful career in the industry, being an Ahmadi Muslim woman. The primary guidance comes from motivation from the Holy Quran, and I urge all of you to please explore the avenues of research from the Holy Quran and have a goal in mind. Allah says, and everyone has a goal which dominates him. Why then with one another? In good works, chapter 2, verse 149. Our beloved Hazur Hazrat Khalifatul Masih, may Allah strengthen his hands, says, believers must have a goal before them, just as other people or nations that set forth of the path of making progress set one for themselves. The second point is, please plan your career very early. Think of what you will do when you grow big. Even as a child, you must start thinking what you are going to be as you grow big. And how will you serve mankind? Then, once you have selected your path, I would recommend that you strive in that path with prayers and perseverance and hard work, and write letters to Hazur for his guidance. And may we be able to fulfill what Hazur has requested in his address, in the concluding address that he delivered at the Ghana Jalsa Salana. Advance so much in every field of education that your minimum target is a Nobel Prize. Jazakumullah.